fooled me and used me in ways that he shouldn't have. And it's hard to think that I trusted him for such a long time and believed in what he had to say to find out that he was going to do something like this, and that I'm not the only one. I'm hurt by this, and I have a hard time trusting people with things that they say now in general, because I don't know who I can trust anymore. Someone who I thought I could trust, I can't.
I struggle with what dialogue I present to the court today in your presence for the first time in almost a year. There was a time when I would have thrown insults and phrases imbibed with unadulterated rage away. There was a time when the very thought of standing here looking at you was so exhausting that words seemed too heavy and tiresome to speak.
He has the persona that is represented in the letters that came to this court: father, neighbor, colleague, therapist. And they all speak very highly of him. But there's another side to the defendant, another persona, and that persona is a sexual predator. As was described, or has been described in this case, there are many victims to the defendant's actions.